Hi guys, Snap here. Just kidding, it's Fused Helios, the paper PIV guy. Today, Spock is going to be doing a little video walkthrough of zPiv. Keep in mind, it's going to be on the testnet, so things might be a little different than the final product. He and the dev team has been working super hard on this, and they're on track to release it for quarter four. So without further ado, let me introduce Spock, and he'll take it away.
Okay, this is a demo of using Zerocoin on testnet. So we'll look here first at our main overview of the wallet. I have about 82,000 PIV and 180,000 Zerocoin PIV, zPIV. These are some previous mints and transactions. So if we go to our privacy tab, you'll see on the right here, this is an overview of those 180,000 zPIV we have, and it tells you how many coins you have for each of the denominations. These are the denominations 1, 5, 10, 50, 100, 500, 1,000, and 5,000. So you can see they're, because of the way we've done this auto mint, they're fairly equally balanced in terms of how many of each. And that was by design so that you don't end up with too many little ones or too many big ones and, you know, not a good spread. So this should make it easier to initially, when you have to spend something, you should be able to find the exact amount or use the exact amount without having to generate change. So here on the left, you have a couple of options. One is to mint Zerocoin, which converts your PIV to Zerocoins, zPIV, and there's also coin control here. And the other option is to spend the zPIV. So first, let's just take a look at, so let's say we're going to mint 6 Zerocoins. So that's going to convert 6 PIV to 6 zPIV. There'll be a little fee charged. We'll hit this and see what happens here. Okay, I have to unlock my wallet. So simple password here for the test PIV. And now let me try that again. And okay, successfully minted. This one was pretty quick. You see the transaction go up here for the last conversion. So if we go to the transaction tab, you should see a 5 and a 1. And there's a 0.02. That should be a 0.01 actually fee. So, oh, I see. Sorry. It is 0.02 because it's 0.01 per coin. So there's 0.01 for the 1 and 0.01 for the 5 to give 0.02 for the 6. Now you would have also seen this number go up by 1 and this number go up by 1. So the other thing you can do is now you've basically made those coins private. So now if you want to pay someone else, all you need is their payment address and you can pay them and it'll be anonymous because you'll create the transaction that converts your Zerocoin into the PIV, but no one else will know that that's actually your Zerocoins. So if I take up the dialogue here, let me just send it to 7hacks. That's an address I'd saved. Let me send him, let's say, 11 Zerocoin. I should have this one exactly as you can see, so there should be no issue there. And when I click this, it asks, you know, about the security level. That's the default. So, but the security level can be between 10 and 100. And it adds some kind of obfuscation to the timing to make it harder to tell when, a Zerocoin was used. 100 being the highest. And in general, you know, this is not needed to tweak this very much. So we'll hit yes, and we should then start seeing a transaction come up here when it's done. So there you go, you see the 11 PIV get sent. The dialog here tells you transaction fee. There's no fee for spending. We do have a fee like shown before for minting. So the spend number 1 was a 10, here's a serial number, spend number 2 was a 1, here's the serial number, value is 11, here's the address as you can see before. It took 30 seconds. So, and if you again go back, you'll see the payment go on here. So, and you'll see it here in this main tab too. course, you can do your normal spends of PIV and your normal receive of PIV here, just as before. And again, this is the main transaction here. So you'll have noticed that this was 39 before, and the 10 was 35, and it's gone down to 34 now, I believe. So let's just do one more case here of the mint. Let's say 256, and you'll see again 2 100s, a 55, and a 1. And let's try another spend. Oh, yeah, to put the amount here. In this case, let's say 27. So that should use 2 10s, a 5, and 2 1s. So this should go down to 32, and this should go down to 37. Try this one. Say yes again. And so this should be a total of 2, 3, 4, 5 coins together that are sent out in that transaction. So in comparison with some other coins like Zcoin, if you actually wanted to send 27, you'd have to do it as 5 separate transactions. So this is really nice because it allows you to combine the amounts. So that's very convenient. Again, I think it'll take a little while because this is a debug version. So while this is going, one other thing you can do is that, for example, if you just had 3 10s, and that's all you had, and you wanted to pay someone 27 PIV or zPIV, keep it anonymous, you basically would end up with 3 PIV, zPIV as change, or 3 PIV as change. So what you can do is convert that change to zero coin. The reason you want to do that is because when you do that, it retains the anonymity. So that what would happen is you'd actually pay 1 PIV for that fee and then get 2 0 PIV in change. But then not only would no one know who sent those PIV, but also who got the PIV in change would be unknown too. Where if you didn't do that and you just got 3 PIV in change, those 3 PIV would probably go to one of your change addresses. And it is possible to tell link addresses together through a wallet, so you would be losing your privacy there to some degree, because someone may start noticing that change address being used later and being able to link then certain transactions. Okay, so you can see that one finished. It took a bit longer, but again, get all the details there. And yeah, so I think that's just pretty much an overview. There's a couple other options here I'm not showing. One is you can still stake same as before. And also, there's an auto mint feature which we may demo a bit later in another video. All right, thanks everyone. See you later.